Nara Narayana. In Dwarka, a Brahmin was losing all his children as soon as they were born. Every time he used to carry the dead body to the royal palace, declare that due to some fault of the ruler, he had lost his son, cry aloud and return back. Nobody took any notice of his bereavement. Ninth time also, he came as usual with the dead body and began to cry. Arjuna, having come there, heard this pitiable cry and promised to help the Brahmin for the next child. The Brahmin minded his words very little and said, "When Sri Krishna and Balarama are keeping silent, who is this fool to boast that he will help?" Arjuna pacified him and promised sure help. The time for the 10th delivery came. The Brahmin informed Arjuna. Arjuna went there and built a network of his sacred arrows so that not even a fly could go out. The delivery took place. The child was born. It cried aloud and the next moment it bodily disappeared. The Brahmin started to shower abuses on Arjuna. Arjuna could not stand them. He ran in search of the baby to Yama, Varuna, Sun, Moon, Rasatala, Sutala, and everywhere he could think of but could not find any trace. Finally, he resolved to give up his life by falling into fire for failing to keep up his word. Lord Krishna was observing the delicate developments affecting Arjuna. He resolved to save him out of his ego. Sri Krishna took Arjuna in his chariot to the abode of the Supreme, which was beyond the three worlds, beyond the seven worlds, and beyond the 14 worlds, beyond all light and darkness. In the darkness, they could not see their way, and so Sri Krishna sent his Sudarshana Chakra in advance, by whose brilliance they could drive their chariot. At last, they reached the abode of Vishnu, who was lying on Adisesha. As soon as the Supreme saw them, he said, "In order to see you both, sages Nara and Narayana, I have brought all the sons of the Brahmin. You have come. You can take the children. Both of you better complete the work of your avatara and return back soon." Thus, Sri Krishna returned with Arjuna and the children. They gave all the children to the Brahmin, who was immensely pleased, and they returned to the palace. Arjuna realized that all his glory and power was mainly due to the grace of Lord Krishna, and that he was doing nothing without his grace. The whole of the 10th chapter, Dashamaskanda of Srimad Bhagavatam, has been interpreted by great acharyas as Vritti Norada. Noradaha, Vritti means mental waves, that is Chitta Vritti, and they have to be resisted. This is said to be one of the ways to reach final beatitude, liberation or moksha. Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodaha. That is, every incident in the life of Sri Krishna, every act whereby he is reported to have killed a demon, is to be interpreted as destruction of one evil thought wave, by which step by step the mind gets purified. Purified mind is but the reflection of the Supreme Atman. When thus understood, the doubt, could Sri Krishna, a young boy, have really killed these demons? Vanishes. They are not demons but demonic thought waves, which are not very difficult for a seeker to destroy. Where there is a will, there is a way. Kaschit dhiraha pratyagatmanam aikshat avrita chakshuhu amrutatvam chin. The rare person, the hero intent on the Supreme, with eyes open, seeks the state of deathlessness. Some commentators have not included Sri Krishna in the 10 incarnations called Dashavatara of the Lord. Sri Krishna was not an avatara. There was no avatarana or fall in his godhood as Sri Krishna. For Sri Krishna was said in the Gita, Aham Atma Matah Sarvam Pravartate Mam Namaskuru Mam Saranam Vraja Aham Moksha Ishyami. Some have described Sri Krishna as Purna Avatara, that is, the supreme unperceivable Lord was available for perception. There was no deficiency in the manifestation of his infinite qualities. He was God in human form.